A fortnight in the sun just isn't enough for some plucky Brits.
Why would we want to be anywhere else?
So they're giving up the day jobs and moving to the four corners of Europe.
Yes.
Whoa, this is very amazing and beautiful.
Join us as we follow them taking a leap of faith.
Who dares wins.
No going back.
So this is it, the start of a new life.
Selling furniture in Portugal, running surfing holidays in Spain.
So this is our home.
And launching cafes in France.
Blimey.
But are they on the path to glory?
Got you.
Or the road to nowhere?
Oh, my goodness.
So, Houston, we have a problem.
Oh, my God. I'm making this worse.
As they begin their new lives in the sun.
Very pleasant.
We are 100% here to stay.
Today in Almeria, two restaurateurs get set for launch.
We are now fully booked for tomorrow, our opening night, which is absolutely fabulous.
But will technical troubles scupper their big day?
Everything's gone into this, so it has to work.
Oh, yes.
In Italy...
Come to Tuscany, they said. You'll have all of groves and vineyards.
Two newbie holiday hosts prepare for festival season.
It is what it is. It's an outside dunny. And by tomorrow, it'll be 48 degrees in there.
And on the Costa del Sol...
Everybody's moving very quickly.
Safety fears prompt a Nottinghamshire family to call in the pros.
I feel sick. I think it's probably best if I go away, lie down, don't watch this.
In the sun-baked region of Almeria, you'll be able to find some of Spain's most beautiful beaches, breathtaking landscapes and prettiest towns, one of which is Mojaca. Populated since the Bronze Age, settlers have included the Greeks, Romans and Phoenicians. Now, unsurprisingly, this picture-perfect seaside town is a popular destination for expats to settle.
Lovely view. Look at that.
Like Fraser from Yorkshire and his business partner Jeanette from Bristol, who now call it home.
No regrets from leaving England.
I've only been here 3 years and I've not been back once and I've got no intentions of going back.
You know, you just sit here and you look around and you think, why would I want to be on the M25? It's a no-brainer, really.
After running successful businesses separately, the pair just leased this property together, where they plan to realise their dream of running a beachside restaurant. But it's fair to say they don't see eye to eye all of the time.
Our strong characters does cause us problems sometimes because we both want to do what we want to do. And I feel, as the older member, that it should be my way or the highway.
But then I feel, as the younger member, I'm more in tune with the youngsters. But we compromise and we do find that level. Eventually.
It's early February, and there's now just 4 days to go until Fraser and Jeanette's restaurant opens for business.
It just makes it a little bit more enclosed, yeah, on this end.
And by the end of today, they're hoping they'll have a safe, fully working kitchen.
So this morning, we've got an engineer for the catering equipment coming in. He's going to check all the equipment for us to make sure it's all working properly and safely, and replace any bits and pieces that we do need for opening next Tuesday. Proper preparation prevents a something performance.
After struggling to find an engineer, the equipment checks are a bit last minute.
Let's see what we've got with the burners.
And with opening day just around the corner, they're keeping their fingers crossed there won't be any nasty, expensive surprises.
They're all working, except for one.
And this one doesn't work.
And that one doesn't work on the back.
OK. All right.
The oven's been fired up. That works.
OK.
The fryer is the only thing. It lights, as you know, from yesterday.
Yeah, we need to take temperature to make sure.
Yeah.
No,
OK.
After a quick rundown of all the problems, all Jeanette and husband Alan can do is anxiously wait while the engineer gets to work.
Working. Oh, yes.
An hour later, the checks are complete.
So this one is all working.
And the results are what they'd been hoping for.
The verdict from the engineer is really good. Everything's working. We need a couple of parts to make the dishwasher more efficient and one small part for the fryer.
So that's good news, which means we can open on Tuesday. Yippee!
Three days later, and after 4 weeks of hard graft, Jeanette Fraser and team have achieved what seemed impossible. They've turned an empty, abandoned shell into a cosy, classy restaurant with an inviting terrace and a fully functioning kitchen.
We're opening tomorrow. It absolutely looks brilliant. It looks amazing. There's been a few tears, seeing it at the end, thinking, yeah, we've done this with our hands. No trades, we've done it all ourselves.
And they're already becoming the talk of the town, with passers-by keen to sneak a peek.
Well, this looks nice.
Yeah. Changed a little.
Yeah.
Changed.
Yeah.
Bar's been moved.
Do you have a menu? Online.
Online.
All right.
All right.
You're welcome.
Bye.
See you soon.
These last few days, we've had loads of people walking past. Are you open? When you're open? What food do you do? Can we book? Can we have a look round? So the interest that we've had has been insane, really.
And there's more good news.
We've had a last-minute booking of 10, but that does mean that we are now fully booked for tomorrow, our opening night, which is absolutely fabulous. Bookings are coming in for the day after, the day after, the day after, and the day after. So I'm quietly pleased that we've got people wanting to come and see us, which is great. It's just fabulous.
Just a few months ago, Fraser was running a cafe bar and food truck, and now he's on the cusp of becoming a fully-fledged restaurateur. But now the trio need the olive tree to start bearing fruit.
We do have to make this succeed because myself, Jeanette and Alan, every bit of finance that we've had has been put into this. We just used every single cent that we had. Everything's gone into this, so it has to work. It will work, but it has to.
Tuscany, in central Italy, is widely regarded as the birthplace of the Italian Renaissance, where artists like Donatello, Da Vinci, and Michelangelo redefined the worldwide cultural landscape. Today, the region is a tourist hotspot, welcoming culture connoisseurs from all around the globe. And one couple who just moved here for good are Ian and Paul from Scotland.
Ready for lunch? Mm-hmm. I'm starving.
I am hungry.
After pushing boundaries in their native Scotland, where they became one of the first gay couples to adopt, they've set their sights on a new challenge in sunnier climes.
Oh, that looks beautiful, eh? What a lovely lunch.
I just wanted to move for the weather. Because living in Scotland, the weather's so awful. We've been on holiday in Italy, what, 7, 8, 9 times? And we fell in love with this area. We definitely wanted to become peasant farmers. We wanted land, we wanted the vineyards, the whole Tuscan dream.
Following an extensive 3-year search, the boys found this farmstead on the outskirts of the town of Anghiari. Set in a 17-hectare estate with olive groves, fruit orchards, a vineyard and wild woods, it epitomised the Tuscan dream they were seeking.
We were looking for a place when we would like to be away from the people. We can be totally on our own. But if we fancy a dinner in town, we're literally only 4 minutes away from a beautiful town of Anghiari.
To fund their new life in Tuscany, Ian and Paul spent the last 14 months renovating the farmstead to match the stunning landscape that surrounds it, creating a home for themselves and 4 self-catered holiday apartments.
He wanted a proper, proper kitchen, one room that was done well, that had everything he wanted. So we created this fantastic kitchen, and this is where we live. This is the main room for
us. This is the space when we spend most of our time.
Yeah.
The farmhouse dates back to the 13th century, and each room restoration is sympathetic to the building's history, some more so than others.
This room just now is used as our bedroom, but this was basically the cellar. The building here used to be a mint for guns. And this is a 13th century safe for the guns.
Hoping to attract well-heeled clients, they also spared no expense when renovating the four holiday lets.
So we are now in the first guest apartment.
You should have seen this when we actually took it over. This room was like a dungeon. There was only a cooker and a sink, nothing else. So Paul built all of the kitchen, did all of the tiling, and then I did the decorating and put all the furniture, the fluffy bits.
And the boys maintained as many of the period features as possible.
These are original Italian tiles made in the place called Prato. They are all hand-painted, and none of two of those tiles are exactly the same.
As well as running their holiday lets, Ian and Paul want to revitalise the farm, restore the vineyard and orchards, and even introduce a herd of Highland cows. But each step of their business plan will take time and money.
Every paradise comes with its downsides, like the amount of work you have to put in to get it sorted. But we're getting there, and it's now turning out to be a pretty special place to be.
It's late July, and the summer season is already in full swing for Ian and Paul.
So when everybody comes here, they think it's all going to be easy and relaxed, but you spend your time doing laundry and gardening. That's it, laundry and gardening every day. There's on average about 3 changeovers a week, and on those days, it's busy. Today, it just so happens we've got 2 changeovers in the one day.
And hoping to carve a niche in the luxury market, the boys take room changeovers to another level.
All the marks on the wall, we'll repaint that today. Between every guest, we'll repaint all the dirty marks. The demographic we're trying to get is middle-aged, middle-class. You come here for a week of, you know, relaxation and calmness and peace.
The diary is filling up for Ian and Paul, but they can't rest on their laurels. So they've decided to lay on an event in the hope of securing more future business.
Anghiari has a music festival. We decided that we were going to sponsor that, so we're one of the main sponsors. Not particularly because we like classical music. We think it's okay, but selfishly, it's actually very good publicity for us. So tomorrow, they're going to come with wind instruments, and they're going to play for about 2 hours, and we're going to provide lunch to all the guests.
The music festival could really put Ian and Paul on the map. So the pressure is on to get every detail right. Coming up, a Nottinghamshire family battle the elements at their Spanish B&B.
So after that ridiculous downpour, I'm worried how long this water's taking to go away.
And in France, a County Durham couple roll their sleeves up to pull in the punters.
We've never done any fence building before, have we? So this is a first. Might be a case of the last as well, if it doesn't work.
It will work.
Here on the Costa del Sol, the sun putting his hat on is something Spaniards take for granted. And with the cost of living here around 25% cheaper than the UK, it's easy to see why more Brits abandon Blighty for Spain than any other country in Europe.
Cheers to Casa Hermosa. Cheers.
One couple who just swapped the British rat race for cost of living are Sarah and Luther from Nottinghamshire.
The thing I love most about Spain is the pace of life. One of my newfound friends says, tranquilo. Everything is tranquilo. It's nice and easy, and I've fallen for it.
Here on the hillside between the coastal resorts of Mijas and Fuengirola, barrister Sarah and former landlord Luther just opened the doors to their newly refurbished B&B. And when it comes to hospitality, the couple have a simple philosophy.
We are going to rent this place out on an individual basis and look after people as best we possibly can.
But moving to Europe hasn't been entirely pain-free. To live and work in Spain full-time, the couple must secure golden visas. They recently submitted their application, but their visa status still hangs in the balance.
because of Brexit now, we're only allowed to stay here for 90 days out of 180. So it's imperative that we get the golden visa.
Until we've got the residency, then I won't feel entirely comfortable. It's all incredibly chaotic, but it'll come. It will come.
And Sarah and Luther's visa status isn't the only cloud currently hanging over their heads. It's mid-May, and after opening the B&B for business, the whole southeast coast has been engulfed by a tropical storm. Two guests are staying at the B&B, with another couple due any minute now, and the terrace is currently under several inches of water.
So, after that ridiculous downpour, I'm worried how long this water's taking to go away. Ah, that's the reason why, because it's blocked.
The villa's storm drains are blocked, and with the terrace already flooded, Luther is worried the rooms could be next.
Yeah, that should work now. And the water flows.
But it's nothing that a knitting needle shouldn't be able to take care of.
There she blows. All four are running. Wasn't expecting to do this at the start of the day. Gotta go and see what damage we've got down here now, then. Oh, hello. Right, so that's obviously coming out quite nicely. All sorted. How are my guests? Have you drowned?
I can't believe I've come all the way for the weather. We've got this.
It's just incredible.
I worked out where the rain was coming from. I realised, actually, you were up there with a knitting needle.
Drain successfully unblocked.
Spot straight down there.
It's down to Luther to give their German guests...
Hello.
Hello there.
And I'm Luther. Nice to meet you.
A warm Spanish welcome.
You like that? What a great reaction. Thank you very much.
I like it, but I don't like Susanna on the hour.
Luckily, the poor weather hasn't put too much of a dampener on Annette and Sven's arrival.
It's a very lovely place. I like it so much. And I hope I can stay longer.
I've had a really, really strange day. And then it's just all been made worthwhile because that lady's face, she just lit up and, you know, having seen her for 30 seconds, she's asked me if she can live here for the rest of her life, you know. Just absolutely fantastic. So even though the weather's horrendous, it is still very special, this place.
It's 4 days later. And with the B&B ticking over nicely, Luther has called in two tree surgeons to address a looming safety problem. These trees are overgrown and hanging dangerously close to the villa, so after checking they're not protected, they've decided to fell them before they fall on the house or visiting guests.
Now, there's no rain, no wind, so that 80-foot tree is about to become 4 foot.
But having given them the green light to proceed, Luther is starting to have second thoughts.
Everybody's moving very quickly. The idea is, if he makes a mistake, I'm going to catch it.
Luther knows that felling trees in a built-up area isn't without its risks.
That's not broken. We're only two branches in, and all of a sudden my life's broken.
Each of these trees could weigh in excess of 10 tons, and there's only one place for the cuttings to fall, onto the garden below.
I didn't like the hedge either, but now the hedge is coming out. Two jobs for the price of one. Always try and look on the bright side.
Bringing down these colossal trees so close to the villa without causing any damage was always going to be a big ask. But with one tree down, one light broken, one hedge dented, and one patio tile cracked, can Luther hold his nerve as they tackle the other two?
I feel sick. I think it's probably best if I go away, lie down, don't wash this.
Northwest France is famously home to the Brittany and Normandy regions, attracting over 8 million holidaymakers each year. Just to the south is the department of Mayenne, famous for cider making and its lush green countryside.
Oh, look at all the daffodils here.
For Maxine and Graham from County Durham, It was love at first sight, so much so that they sold up in England and set down roots here.
It was just something we always, always, we don't know why, always wanted to do it.
Yeah.
We didn't want south of France heat all the time.
No.
We still wanted seasons, easy access to the UK. And it was just, as soon as we came out on holiday in France, it was like, yeah, this is it. Mm-hmm.
For just €300,000, they bought this 2.5-acre country estate, 3-bed farmhouse, and separate 3-bed gîte, which they're hoping will fund their new life here.
We viewed this in August, drove down the drive and just went, that's it. It was a case of, oh, yeah, this is lovely.
It's May, and Maxine and Graham launched their holiday let business 4 weeks ago.
Right, down about 5 centimetres.
And so far, there's been a steady stream of guests keeping them busy.
It's been eventful, Graham. Are we still enjoying life in France?
Yeah, of course. Yeah. It's not always glamorous and sitting, drinking a glass of wine or something in the sun, but...
We've had guests in who have loved it. Mm-hmm. So far, so good.
But competition for customers in this area is high, so the couple are keen to unleash their secret weapon, an on-site swimming pool.
I wish the dog could help.
But before they pull off the pool cover, they need to erect a fence around the area to make sure it's safe for visiting families.
So the fence that we're putting up is just going to go along this edge here and up, so it stops the potential of anybody falling into the little stream that runs through, isn't it?
Yeah.
We've never done any fence building before, have we? So this is a first. Might be a case of the last as well, if it doesn't work.
It will work.
Each fence post must be concreted into position,
right,
with a quick setting mix.
Spot on. This in first and then the water, yeah? I've put too much water in, haven't I?
Too much water and the concrete won't set.
I'm not jinxing it, but this is going well.
Oh, you've done it now. You've said it was going well. That's it, jinxed.
And it seems Graham's prediction was spot on.
I've got an issue.
What?
We're a poor short.
Are we?
Well, we measured 6 yesterday, but then looking at the spaces now, we need 7.
But Graham has a plan. If the wire mesh will stretch to an existing fence post, they can secure it there.
Yeah, might be able to put some clips in there.
Attach it to the post?
Yeah.
Right, job sussed.
But to use the old post, first they need to clear a path to it.
Just a lot more clearing up to do than we expected, but that's part of the course, isn't it?
With the area finally cleared, they can turn their attention back to the fence.
I mean, we've got plenty, so if we're over-unroll, it doesn't matter. Yeah.
The posts have set perfectly, so now all they need to do is unravel the mesh...
Get it out there, do you think?
..and attach it.
OK. Is it hard?
No.
Oh, no, it's not.
No.
And in no time at all, their hard work has finally paid off.
Is that right?
Yeah, it looks.
Yeah, well done.
That looks really good, doesn't it? Right.
Come on, Coco.
Come on,
our day's done.
Come on, good girl.
With the peak summer season just around the corner, Maxine and Graham are hoping the swimming pool will help take their accommodation to the next level.
It's starting to look good.
Yeah.
Nice, secure and safe for guests.
Well, that was the main thing, wasn't it? The safety for the guests.
Yeah.
And for our peace of mind that they were OK. Mm-hmm. So they didn't fall in the stream.
So well done.
Brilliant day. Cheers.
Yeah, cheers.
Cheers. Well deserved. Mm.
But will it be enough to secure their long-term future here in France? Coming up, in Italy, Ian and Paul divide to conquer.
Ta-da!
But could a PR push send their relationship down the pan?
Oh, Paul's out in his little motorbike or in the car having a little tour around Tuscany, and I'm here scrubbing the bathrooms.
And in Spain...
Evening. How are you doing? You all right?
A mechanical mishap hits Jeanette and Fraser's restaurant opening.
There's a problem with the till system. They're getting confused with what they're putting their tickets on. It's all right. It's first night.
Back in Tuscany, Ian and Paul are still adapting to life as holiday hosts.
This is what it's all about. Come to Tuscany, they said. You'll have olive groves and vineyards. They didn't say anything about hoovering under the beds.
It's late July, and in the hope of boosting future bookings in their luxury holiday lets, tomorrow the boys will host a music festival. And while Paul picks up supplies, Ian has drawn the short straw.
Well, Paul's out in his little motorbike or in the car having a little tour around Tuscany looking for Cantucci, and I'm here scrubbing the bathrooms.
Today, Ian and Paul will be juggling apartment guests with preparations for their first ever music festival. So with Paul back, it's time to take stock.
We've got this apartment to finish, the apartment upstairs to get ready for guests. Then we need to get the tables and chairs moved, but we could do that in the morning.
No, not in the morning. In the morning, we'll be too busy.
I've nearly finished the kitchen. I just need to check that they've got everything.
Apartment's finally clean. The boys can focus on their festival plans.
It is what it is. It's an outside dunny, as we say in Scotland. And by tomorrow, it'll be 48 degrees in there.
And while Ian prepares the grounds, Paul is in charge of catering.
So I'm going to make a raspberry cake, a very simple recipe, and it comes out beautiful every time.
But Paul is having a few technical problems.
Unfortunately, the knob on the robot broke off, so now it works like that. Ta-da!
While Paul gets cracking with his raspberry cakes...
OK. And it goes.
Outside, Ian is making sure the grounds are in tip-top shape for tomorrow's festival. But with most of Europe currently enduring record-breaking temperatures, it's easier said than done.
The problem here is the heat kills everything. You get a few couple of months where the plants look great, and then before you know it, they're dead. So today, because we've got the big festival on tomorrow, everything has to look as best it can. Probably the best opportunity for advertising.
In an area where holiday accommodation is easy to come by, Ian is hoping that tomorrow's festival will help set them apart from the competition.
Because really this is the first year, we've found it a challenge, I suppose. There's two apartments that we can rent, no problem at all, but the others, they're new, they don't have so many reviews. But we're hoping that obviously the more people that come, the more people that leave good reviews.
But with 17 hectares of land to maintain, the job is never ending.
When you move to Italy, the thing you don't realise, you buy this big farm with beautiful ground, and you don't understand it will be a constant piece of work, inside and outside.
Back in the kitchen, Paul is adding the finishing touches to his raspberry cakes.
Made this cake many times and it's always turned out fantastic. The more raspberries you will add to that, the better it comes out, because there is a lovely sourness to the cake.
Ian and Paul are going all out to impress their musical visitors.
Ta-da!
And as well as advertising their new holiday lets, Ian hopes the event will help cement their place within the local community.
We do have a philanthropic approach to Anghiari. We want to give to the local people there. So I think it's about opening yourself up to be seen as opening up, that you're not behind these big gates, you're not living this idyllic life, but shut out from everyone else. I think it's about saying, look, come in, have a look, see what we've got to offer, be part of it.
After a week of preparations, the stage is almost set for Ian and Paul's first ever music festival. But will the event live up to the stunning venue and help take their business to the next level? Back in Mohaka, it's February the 14th.
I never applauded before.
And Fraser and Jeanette are hoping there'll be some love in the air for their restaurant when they finally open for business tonight.
So it's opening day, so we've only got one chance to make a good impression on the first day. We've still got quite a lot of things that need doing, but they'll get down eventually. Tonight it's just about giving them good food, good service, and enjoying what we do.
And it's also about bringing in some much needed cash.
It's really important that we get open tonight and we take some money so that the guys can get some pay now, because they've put their heart and soul in it for us for 4 weeks. So, yeah, we need to get open so they can have some money and they can all go off and enjoy themselves now for a night out.
They have 46 covers to get out on time tonight, so Fraser and Jeanette have hired two extra staff to take the pressure off front of house. But Jeanette only has limited time to show them the ropes.
Coffee. In. Pull the handle. In the damper. Press it down. OK?
Yeah.
So this is if you're making one with frothy milk, and this is what if somebody just wants a little bit of milk.
And as the sun sets, it's time for service to begin. And Fraser's ready to welcome their very first customers.
Are you all right?
Hi.
Are you doing all right?
Yeah,
okay. Want to follow me? I'll show you the table, all right?
And several more diners are hot on their heels.
Evening. How you doing? You all right?
As a few tables arrive early...
All right. Hello. You ready to order?
Within half an hour, the restaurant is heaving.
Ladies first.
Thank you.
There you are. You know the score, don't you?
And the newly formed front of house team are feeling the pressure.
It's very busy. A bit stressful. But OK, tranquila. Yeah, we're busy, but you know what? Everyone's being very patient. They're all saying relax, they're not going to wait. It's fine, no problem. So everything's all right, everything's fine.
But as the orders come in thick and fast...
So send 10 starters, one burger.
Gracias.
There's some confusion with the new till and table numbering system.
Is that right? Bar 5.
No.
No. Which one?
Right, so this food needs to go on to 4.
Tris, only 2. One fish set, one burger. And they've had a brownie.
But that's the 4 in the corner.
It's not. That's restaurant 5, which is down in the corner. This is bar 5, which is where it's getting confused.
Yeah, so restaurant 5...
Yeah, should be them. There's a problem with the till system. The problem is it's so close to being bar 5 and bar restaurant 5 that they're getting confused with what they're putting their tickets on. So therefore I'm having to swap them over now, otherwise people will get the wrong bills at the end of the day. But don't worry. It's the first night. It's expected.
The teething troubles means that some of the orders are delayed getting to the tables.
Is that sauce coming?
But it seems the food was well worth the wait.
Oh, the food was brilliant. Yeah, absolutely top-notch. And a really good ambience. Lovely. Really enjoyed it.
With one last push, they make it to the end of service.
See you later. Enjoy your evening.
And it's certainly been a testing first night for the new team.
Few hiccups.
Yeah.
Not our fault. Technical issues with computer systems, of which we're not liable.
But all in all, feedback from customers. Yeah.
Yeah, 39 good, 6 not.
Yeah, which is, you know what? I can cope with that.
Yeah.
I can cope with that.
Yeah, absolutely.
It might not have been perfect, but they pulled it off.
Cheers, Fraser.
Cheers.
Brilliant night.
Mm, well done.
But they need to iron out any problems fast to make sure they keep the bookings and books coming in. Coming up, something's lost in translation for Maxine and Graham.
That ain't nowhere near enough. You know, and you should have ordered twice as much.
And in Spain...
2 down, 1 to go. What's the worst that could happen?
Luther and Sarah brace for impact at their B&B.
Oh, this is going the wrong way now. Look, straight towards me.
Back in northwest France, it's the middle of June, and business at Maxine and Graham's holiday let has been steady since they started trading 10 weeks ago. Around half of their visitors have been French holidaymakers, and for Maxine, every day is a school day.
Our lovely guests are teaching me French. So yesterday I said, what, you're welcome in French, and it...
Bien. Bienvenue.
Bienvenue. And then my pleasure.
Avec pleasure.
Avec pleasure.
Plaisir.
Plaisir. Plaisir. Avec plaisir.
Très bien, très bien.
Merci.
Maxine and Graham recently fitted a safety fence around their swimming pool with the hope of opening it in time for summer. But an increase in visitors has meant the pool is still under wraps.
First job is to open the pool, give that a clean.
Make get sure the bugs out.
Yeah, get the bugs out, test the water, make sure that's okay. And then the guests can use it for the rest of the day.
Yeah.
But since moving here 3 months ago, the couple have yet to check what lurks under the tarpaulin. So first they need to find out if the water is safe.
What we're doing is just doing a test on the alkaline and the pH value to make sure it's right for the guests. We'll just pop the strip in.
If the pH is too high or low, it won't be safe to use, and their current guests could be left disappointed.
pH is perfect. Maybe just a little bit of chlorine in when you get round to it, yeah.
It's the perfect, if unexpected, result. And with the addition of a couple of chlorine tablets, the pool is finally guest ready.
Right.
Now, shall we take the cover off?
Yes, and then I'll put the pump on.
Your way, darling. Yeah.
This on-site pool should help boost summer bookings and the couple's coffers.
Not too bad, is it?
No, it's okay.
But on closer inspection, there's one fly in the ointment.
Just halfway on the next one, love, is a big bug.
After a quick sieve, the only thing that will be creating a buzz now is the newly opened crystal clear swimming pool.
They weren't expecting the pool open.
But we wanted it.
We really wanted to get it open for them. Yeah. And so, yeah, that was a learning curve in itself, wasn't it, really?
Yeah.
We've never had a pool.
Bagging a good review is Maxine and Graham's number one priority. So some jobs will have to wait for another day.
A lot of what we need to do now is strimming and noise.
Yeah, just keeping on top of the grass and things like that. But we'll do that
tomorrow. They've left. Yeah. So, yeah, fingers crossed we'll have a little bit more of a down day.
Yeah.
What's one of them?
I was just about to say, I don't know what that is.
But the couple have bigger plans afoot to boost business. A week later, and with their guests gone, they're preparing to add another exciting addition to their holiday let.
Plan today to complete the footings for the hot tub. It's, where are we now? June. It's not coming till the end of August, but we've only got one more gap because after that we're back to back with guests and we can't disturb them in the garden.
No.
Oh, the wall.
Arriving today is hardcore.
Is it clearing the wall?
No, it's fine, yeah.
To lay under a new patio on which the hot tub will stand. But it's a bit of a squeeze getting the delivery down the driveway.
How much? It's going to make the job so much easier, though, being down here, but I didn't think he'd do that. Oh, God, he's away then. Now, where's he gone? Amazing! Fabulous!
But now there's a bigger problem.
That ain't nowhere near enough. You know, and you should have ordered twice as much. There's no way that's going to do the job.
The couple only have 2 days before their next guests arrive, and without the right materials to finish the job, their hot tub plans could be on hold, and any potential bookings they might generate lost. In Mijas, B&B owners Sarah and Luther have called in the experts to remove several overgrown eucalyptus trees that they're worried might fall on their house or guests.
Two down, one to go. What's the worst that could happen?
But the trees have grown so close to the villa that bringing them down without causing any damage below is proving almost impossible. The wind is also beginning to pick up, making the direction in which the branches fall more unpredictable.
Oh, this is going the wrong way now. Look, straight towards me.
Oh,
go swimming. Lovely.
Swimming.
I think we're all right.
Luckily, the stray branch didn't damage the pool terrace.
Whoa!
Whoa. Not a problem. Wanted a new pool anyway.
Seeing stray branches fall into the swimming pool is dramatic proof that the couple were right to take action. And some minor damage is preferable to an injured guest in the future.
I've got a light to replace, but the light was broken anyway. I've got a tile to replace, but I'd broken a couple of tiles previous to that, so I've got to get them done. It's not a problem. Nothing's a problem.
Removing the trees was a decision Sarah and Luther made with a heavy heart.
Look at this.
But safeguarding their customers has come with an added bonus.
You can see the sea. Properly see the sea. It's good.
It had to be done, but it's quite a shock.
A few days later, Sarah and Luther are getting ready for a busy May half term. And after a surge in bookings, they're busier than ever.
What have you been buying?
Everything.
I can see that.
Since they got the keys 3 months ago, the couple have been slowly revamping their 5 B&B rooms.
I think this is the most people I'll have had in my house ever. So it'll be 8 people stopping. So the pressure's on.
And to attract family bookings, now they want to introduce a family-friendly space.
So we've got these two occupied today, and these two are going to be occupied later on as well. So I want to keep these two rooms separate from this family area. So I'm going to put a curtain across so that when they walk to the bathroom, they've got a little bit of privacy.
With barrister Sarah still working for clients in the UK, Luther was tasked with setting up the family zone.
Anyone would think I was a professional.
But with only 45 minutes left to finish the job, Sarah has been forced to pitch in.
I've just decided to call Luther last minute Luther, as everything's always done at the last minute.
Idea is that the curtain will hang there. Next job.
But that next job will drop onto Sarah's list, as Luther needs to do the airport run.
OK, doll, all done.
See you later. Ow! That was my butt. He's completely sold me up to Swanee, because he said he'd have all this done.
And it turns out that Sarah hasn't quite made it to the bottom of Luther's catalogue of unfinished jobs.
I thought that only two rooms needed doing. Actually, three need doing. And I've now got to do the bedding for the third.
And Sarah needs to get her skates on.
All right, I think that'll have to do. Never been known for my ironing skills.
As Luther is back from the airport with their new arrivals.
Right. Oh, that's it.
Where is it? Go on, then.
Oh, my gosh.
So I'm putting the curtain across there, so this is just your area.
This is just our wing.
OK, so that's your room.
Yes.
Yeah, and then in here...
bathroom.
Will that do you?
Yeah.
The views are amazing, aren't they? Yeah, I really, really like it.
I think it's just got a really nice ambience to it. I mean, we've only been here a few hours and I feel like I've been here a week. Yeah, really good.
Their B&B rooms are proving popular, but Sarah and Luther could make a bigger profit by renting out the whole villa during the peak summer months.
We've just got to get the summer holiday situation sorted.
July and August.
Which we can't do until we know whether we've got our visa and whether we're allowed to go back to the UK.
Which we'll find out in the next few days.
Hopefully.
But if their visa application is refused, they could be packing their bags and returning to England for good. Next time... can Ian and Paul ride out an unseasonal storm?
I really just want to go home to Scotland.
In Spain, success comes at a cost for Jeanette and Fraser.
I'm back in the kitchen. After many years of retirement, because, you know, just can't get any staff.
And also for Sarah and Luther.
We ended up with 4 more people than we were expecting last night. There was one point where 2 of them were going to sleep in the bar.
And plumbing problems hit Maxine and Graham.
Graham, it's totally blocked.
and all the water's coming back up.